Alaska Garden. I'm with UAF Cooperative Extension Service and Tanana Chiefs Conference. I'm here in Homer, Alaska, checking out all the cool things farmers are doing here to extend the season, like high tunnels, hoop houses, low tunnels, and also the other cool tools they're using as small-scale farmers. I'm here at Oceanside Farms in Homer, Alaska with Don McNamara, and he's going to show us how he makes biochar. So Don, what's so great about biochar?
Biochar is condominiums for microorganisms. And when you put it in your compost pile, they all just swarm right in there. It's like a new house sale.
Nice. So it's a great thing for organic farming and soils?
And soil building, yeah. So organic farming is all about building soils. Any way you can do it, improve your soil.
Okay, so how do you make biochar?
It's combustion with no air. So we use a tank like this and we fill it as full as we can with 2x material. It's good to use kiln dried material. If you try and use logs and things like that, they won't dry out as well. Mm. Might take a couple burnings to get to the work. But like this, it's going to be just like that in about 3 hours.
So what kind of wood are you using?
We're using old pallets and debris left over. We just built a house a year ago, so getting rid of the wood pile. Recycle, reuse. So the pallets are easy to come by in Homer. You know, they ship them up and they don't really want to ship them back. So
they're
free for the taking.
Another great way to recycle.
Yeah.
Reuse.
So I think what we'll do is put the lid on this and then we'll put it in the 55-gallon drum and go to the next step.
And how big is this container?
This is about a 30-gallon drum. And we got this at the local metal recycler's place there.
And so it's all filled up with wood, and then you've got some holes here on the top.
Yep, so we'll just take this lid and put it right on there. And we'll pin it together.
And you use nails to hold it on?
I used to use screws, but the holes just kept getting wobbled out. So.
Okay. All right, so you're gonna put this smaller barrel into the larger barrel?
Yep, so we wrestled that lid right on there and we used some nails in these little tiny holes to hold the lid in. So really this is the bottom. And so we're gonna roll a 55-gallon drum over because this thing is so heavy, an old timer couldn't pick it up. We get it to about there and I'll watch my fingers.
Oh. Nice. So that's inside there. And then why do you have the holes on the outside of the outer barrel?
We have that to let some combustion air in and we'll put the chimney on top of it and it'll just be a roaring inferno in no time flat.
Nice.
Yep. But the first thing we're gonna have to do is call and check in with the troopers and make sure it's okay we can burn today.
Right.
Hi, this is Don McNamara. I'd like to use my burn permit.
Oh, okay. And where are you going to be burning?
It's 58508 East End Road, Homer.
Okay. And you have equipment there, water, it's going to be monitored?
Yes, it sure will be.
Okay.
Thank you. Bye.
So there's a little space between the inner barrel and the outer barrel here.
Yeah, so there's a little space around the inner and the outer barrel, about an inch and a half, and we'll just take these boards and fill that space, and yep.
So then when it's all done, you smash it up? and add it to your compost. And since you had pallets, you've got a something to get those nails out?
Yeah, so we use a magnet and roll on there to get the nails out. And that's how they kind of come. And then we use a 5-gallon bucket to pick them up.
Okay.
The biochar smashes pretty darn easy.
Wow.
So he's a 10-pound sledgehammer.
Looks like good stuff.
Yeah, we're hoping that little plants and animals like it.
All right, well, thanks, Don, for showing us how you make biochar.
And away we go.